As he thought.
What a shame.
His almighty brain began to shape and make and dream and fret. And so he devised his eternal plan, making all things exist as they should. That includes you and me, every woman and man. And God said,
"That's really good."
He was full of delight as he cut day from night by the light of the moon and the sun. And he dusted his hands and thought of his plans. And God said,
"This creation is fun."
He stretched out his hand and molded the land. Plants, fruit and grain, and the woods, and around it the sea, and the sand, and the beach. And God said,
"That's really good."
The Lord looked around. There was hardly a sound.
"That's too quiet,"
he said. And a throng of the bees and the birds and their beasts in their herds sprang alive with a burst and a song.
"Now to finish my plan, I'll make woman and man living just like me, tending earth as they should. And each day we'll talk and enjoy a good walk." And I say, "That's really good."
Then the Lord took a rest. He had done his best.
And he smiled.
And he smiled as he looked all around.
From the waves.
From the waves and the seas and the wind in the trees, there rose up a magnificent sound. From the mountains so high and the wide open skies, and the oceans, the plain and the wood, everything, great and small, joined the song of it all. And God said,
"That's really good."
Oh,
beginning. God made man and woman, like himself, able to think and to reason, and to talk with him. He gave them a beautiful garden to live in and to tend, and all the creatures of the earth to watch over and name. It was all very good in the beginning.
Tree. Bird. Flower. Cat.
Rat. Rat. Rhinoceros.
No, no. Not rhinoceros. How about cheetah?
Cheetah. Cheetah's body with long legs, gone before you look at it. No, this is something more twine. Loop. Slide.
Sausage. Saucepan? No, wait for it. I've got it. Snake. Strange eyes, this snake of yours.
Well, you'd have a strange look if your eyes were on top of your head. Look, I'm nearly done with the day. Just want to sit and enjoy.
So good. So many different creatures with different eyes and teeth.
And legs and whiskers.
And all of us here together with God.
Over there somewhere. But it's really juicy, and you should try.
just a little something to cover us up.
From it. What are you wearing?
disobey you. Snake, because of your lies, you will be cursed to crawl in the dirt, and your descendants and theirs will be enemies from now on. That is how it shall be, until at last a man bangs a snake on the head as it wounds him on the heel.
Lord, what will become of us? Will we really die?
Eve, because of what you have done, you will bring your children into the world of pain. Adam, the world will no longer give you the food you need, except after hours and months of hard work.
But we can still walk with you in the garden, can't we?
Because you chose to go your way, and not mine, you'll have to leave my garden forever.
Eve, what have we done?
Hard work and pain.
For us and our children.
And their children.
And grandchildren.
Forever.
If only we could talk with God, like we used to.
But now the snake whispers, listen to me. If only we could walk with God like we did before.
But now the snake whispers, walk with me.
If only we hadn't listened to that snake.
If only we hadn't done what he said. Such a little thing, an apple.
Such a big thing, disobeying God. Won't somebody bang that snake on the head?
Eve had to leave God's garden. And in every generation, God called out, I love you. Listen to me. Follow me. But the snake that coiled in human hearts whispered its alternative. And people became more and more cruel and violent until God had enough. As God looked down sadly, he saw Noah. One good man among so much sin. Noah and his family will be saved together in the ark.
Noah! Noah! Oh well, he can't go find his rabbit warren in the ark. Rabbit warren, did we really only bring two rabbits with us? A nice romantic little cruise, Noah told me. Although there'll be a bit of boat building to do first. And of course, we'll take the kids. Oh, and by the way, he said, as an afterthought, did I tell you we have to take two of every living creature as well? Everything, including the ones you don't fancy, like spiders, or scorpions, or snakes. Oh! How long has it been now, bobbing up and down, wondering if God has forgotten us after all? And the wind, and the rain, and the rolling round of greenest grass, all because of Noah listening to God, even when people made fun of him. Noah told you to build an ark in a desert. Now, which God was that Noah? The one in your head? But Noah listened, and here we are, cooped up together, safe and sound. Trying not to smell the animals. Trying not to smell each other, actually. Beginning to wonder if all this togetherness is a bit overrated. And everyone's falling out and moaning over the chores.
Aren't you there yet, Mum? It's not fair! Why do I have to knock out the hippos again? And Shed's only got to be the zebras.
And Japhet's off somewhere. No one knows where, and yes, it probably should be his turn today. Noah, where are you? And why don't you tell me what hard work this nice little cruise of yours is going to be?
Here I am, dear. Did you call? Turn out fine today.
Turn out fine? Know how much longer I'm going to be on this ark?
God didn't exactly say how much longer. But look on the bright side, at least we're all together, safe and sound.
Yes, together, safe and sound. And so sick of water.
far the water's gone. Look, look, yourself. It's come back with a twig. See? It must mean that there's trees out there. Yeah, there's dry land at last.
Dry
yes,
land?
Yes, dry land.
Shem, hurry, Japhet.
Where is Japhet?
Oh, up here, man.
Quick, look. Dry land.
Yes!
Now, come along quickly and no pushing. No, Tom, it's not your turn to go first, nor is it yours either, Shem. Your father will decide who goes first. Isn't that right, Noah? Noah!
First, give thanks. Noah, because you listened to God and obeyed him, this is his promise to you. Never again will I destroy the earth like this. See the rainbow arched up between earth and heaven. This is the sign of my promise to you, to your descendants, and to all creatures forever.
After all, we waited so long for the son that you promised us. You said that you'd make us a great nation, a blessing to all. And then you asked this: take your son, Isaac, up the mountain and I will show you where you must kill him as a sacrifice to me. Lord, you've led us so far. All that we have is yours. But did it have to be this, our only son?
Promise to you, I will give you you as many descendants as there are stars in the sky, and all the nations on the earth will be blessed through them.
Mile after mile under the sun, danger behind every bush, not even a guidebook to hand. Think I'd be tired enough to sleep? I've tried everything. Hot drinks, good story, counting sheep, goats, vultures, snakes. The only story banging around in my head is my own. That's a horror story if there ever was one. Brothers out for murder, parents taking sides, family breakdown all the way. Grandfather Abraham. This should be mine, I know. Why would God ever want to bless me? I mean, after all I've done,
secret place in loneliness in the night. In deepest dark, where no friend ever comes. Deep inside, in my heart, where the serpent hides.
God called once again, "I love you, listen,
follow me, and I will lead you home to freedom and to plenty. But even following God had many ups and downs. Led by Moses, the Israelites were on their way to the home God promised. And they were still not entirely or even obedient.
wander round and round this desert even longer, just because you thought you knew your ways were better than God's.
Ladies and gentlemen, there will now be a 15-minute break. Refreshments are served. Thank you.
Now
is John. John, given to us as a sign, not just to Elizabeth and myself, but to everyone. Praise the Lord God of Israel, for he has visited and redeemed his people, as he promised our father Abraham. This child shall go before the Lord and prepare his way for salvation.
Sorry, no. kingdom comes in the name of the Lord.
The agony of body and of soul.
of human loneliness and of scorn. God's son, excluded from his father's side.
And these are words that from his agony are spilled. Father, forgive! Forgive them this! As Jesus on the cross is lifted high.
With you.
better. All right.
It is him! I don't recognize his voice anywhere. And then there's a note from his hand. I told you we saw him in the garden. But you wouldn't believe us. It is him.
Although I haven't the best idea about Chambly.
He promised he wouldn't believe us. But I never understood.
All the promises and the miracles, they weren't lies, they're all true. They told us it was talking too much to be true.
But it is true. All of it. I don't understand, and yet I've seen it with my own eyes.
Yeshua, the Messiah, our Lamb of God. Are you going to stay with us, Father? Isn't that how you're going to change the world?
That's what I'm sending all of you out to do.
Change the world? Us? But we couldn't.
You've listened to me. You've got to know me. Go out to the whole world.
The whole world?
Go to every corner of the earth and spread out the good news of me.
Preach, I couldn't preach.
Just go and tell people what you've seen and heard. Isn't that what you do every day at the market? Or gossiping at the well?
Well, yeah, it's
buried. The Son of God, living with us, flesh and blood, like us. That's what we'll tell them.
Jesus, showing us what God's really like. Love that doesn't end, even when we don't deserve it.
The Lamb of God, the baptizer called him. The Lamb of God, who comes to take punishment for the sins of all of us. Just as God promised all those centuries ago. I think I'm beginning to understand.
Come with us, Lord. We can teach and preach and heal and all of it if you are with us.
I will be with you. Wasn't I with you, Peter, when you walked on water?
Walked on water, but you never said.
I will always be with you, each one of you, wherever you go, even till the end of time itself. Listen to me. Follow me, and I will always love you, just as I have loved you from the very beginning.
Jesus is God's truth and grace. In the life he lives and the love that he gives, we know, we see God face to face.
Thank you.
tradition, we're going to thank all those who've made this possible, especially Mike, who basically kept us all going. And Matt Osgood and all the band, thank you so much.
Ignoring your soul.